So the next thing I want to work on is getting the horse to respond to pressure. Responding to pressure is how we communicate with horses. We apply pressure, the horse responds, we reward the horse. Now in racing, horses don't necessarily respond to pressure the way we need them to respond to pressure in general equestrian riding or riding in any form. What usually happens with racehorses is they respond at one end of the spectrum. One would be they push into pressure and move against it, or they run away from pressure. And neither of them are any good to us when we're trying to train a horse. We need the horse to give us a response to pressure, which is reasonable. We apply pressure, the horse responds, he gets rewarded. What I'll often do when I go to look at a horse for the first time is control his nose and apply a bit of pressure on his poll. And how he responds to that pressure on the poll will give me an indication as to how he's going to respond to pressure in general. If he moves easily away from the pressure, that's what I'm after. If he pushes against my hand, chances are he's going to push against pressure all the time. If he panics about my hand being there, then he's obviously sensitive. I'm going to have to be a little bit more careful. So when I work with the horse, whether it's on his body or whether it's with the bit in his mouth or whether it's touching him with the whip, I need him to give me a gentle response to pressure that is acceptable, that's workable for me and for the horse, so that the communication is very clear. Okay, so the first thing I might do is I might place my thumbs in the center of the horse's chest and ask him to move back off that pressure. Now I want to apply light pressure, and the moment the horse responds, I want him to be rewarded for it. The idea is to give the horse a really easy task that he's going to get an understanding for. And you'll see when the horse starts to get an understanding of what I'm trying to do, he'll start to lick his lips. Swallow the idea if you like, and then I can start to move on. So I might ask him to move his hindquarters off to the left or to the right. I might ask him to move his shoulders. And then I might move to putting the bit in his mouth and getting the correct response from the bit in the horse's mouth. Making sure that he understands when he feels light pressure on the bars of his mouth, that he understands that he needs to respond either left or right. Now for a lot of racehorses, they don't get that sort of technical detail in the way that the bit is handled in a racing situation or in a training situation. But for what we want to do, the horse has to be much more fine-tuned to what happens to the bit in his mouth. So I need to make sure that I can get a nice flexion in the pole from the right and the left with the right sort of contact on the horse's mouth. So what we need to make sure is that when I apply pressure to the horse's mouth, left or right, that he gives us the right response.